Previously on Scorpion.
Will you please marry me?
No, can't. I'm married to someone else.
Ralph, I was so worried about you. I'm so glad you're okay.
I'm glad you're okay, too.
You took my son into the canyons near landslides and accidents, and you brought him home safe.
Meet my new trainee, Tim Armstrong.
Hello?
So I wanted to ask if you would like to go to the Lake Tahoe Jazz and Heritage Festival.
Oh,
With Tim.
You're a genetic fluke. So freaking what? It doesn't matter. What matters in life is love. You pushed your love out the door to spend the weekend with another man.
And where are you going?
I'm gonna stop Paige. I love her. I'm a moron.
Blackjack 1, if I imagine things, and just pull a quick nose up with the tight roll back there.
Roger that, Blackjack 2. And if I were in big, I'd have set up for a high side gun pass and lit you up.
Negative. I would have bail rolled right out of the situation.
What the hell?
Was that a curse word, Blackjack 1?
I don't think I've ever heard you.
What's wrong?
Are you accelerating?
None of my demand. Plane is not responsive.
Same here. Gaining altitude. Sig is dead. Last all comms to Ranger. Can you connect the base?
No joy.
Okay, stand by to eject. Punch outs are no go.
What's wrong?
Are you trying to lock in on me?
I'm not doing anything. My bird's gone rogue.
June, get off of my six.
Riley, my cyber's a gun hot. You have to shake me now.
5 miles from destination. Tahoe Crystal Lake Resort.
Almost there. What do I say when I see her?
Poetry.
Poetry?
Paige, to Tim, please say nada, but say si to my giant medulla oblongata.
How much tequila have you had?
Enough to write that poem. Look, well...
Just speak from your heart. Can you do that?
No.
Then try this.
You can't spell hypothalamus without us. Huh? Hello? Well... You go get him, Tiger. Okay. That's fine, happy subby.
Yeah, I can't remember the last time I had a Nutsy Cluster Bar.
I can't remember the last time I had a date go so sideways.
Oh, come on, it's not your fault.
No, it's just, this place is famous, where it's 24-hour dining room, so I figured we would get a late meal, sit on the terrace under the moonlight. Instead, it's Nutsy Cluster Bars from the vending machine.
You could not predict that the Board of Health would close the place, and, you know, the reservation mix-up was a fluke.
Let me ask you something.
Mm-hmm.
Were you a little bit relieved that they messed up our adjoining suites?
What? No? Why would you ask that?
Honestly, I thought I picked up on a vibe at the garage that maybe you wanted to stay there. And look, I know this is weird. Like, we've only been on a couple of dates, and then Walter sends us on some romantic weekend getaway. And, you know, I thought maybe you'd be relieved that the only rooms they had were single rooms on opposite sides of the resort. Look, what I'm trying to say, Paige, is... I like you. A lot. And if there's anything holding you back in L.A., then just let me know. I'll understand.
No. There's nothing holding me back.
You sure?
Yes.
Well, that is good news. Cave's ring, and I have to answer Cave's ring. I'm so sorry.
Duty calls.
Hey, boss man, what's up?
I hate to ruin your weekend, but I need you back here pronto. We got a problem.
Cave, why are you calling so late?
Where the hell are you? I'm at the garage, and the doc said you went out, and I need you back here now.
Might be a while.
What's a while?
7 hours.
7 hours? What the hell are you doing 7 hours away from here? Tahoe. Oh, boy.
Telling me.
Okay, you can destroy your personal life later. Right now, I need you to get to Plimpton Airfield. It's just south of the lake. I sent a plane to pick up Paige and Tim.
I cannot get on a plane with them.
You can and you will. I need Team Scorpion, and all I got is a drunk behaviorist.
Hungover behaviorist.
Happy and Sly are on their way. I need you to move your ass, because what I'm about to tell you is going to make all our other cases look like warm-ups.
Happy's on her way?
Yeah. And you need a pot of coffee and some mouthwash, in that order.
Okay, strapped in, ready to go.
Can't sit waiting on one more.
One more? But who?
Hello?
Hello? What are you doing here?
Well, all our talk about jazz music made me want to go see the festival, so here I am. But Kate called, so no music for me.
All right, wheels off. Time's wasting. Kid, we got here as fast as we could.
We brought the kid.
He's 11. I'm babysitting. I can't leave him alone.
You were scared to take the bus at night by yourself.
Shouldn't you be sleeping? Any developments since you called, kid?
No. Admiral Horton Pace should be here shortly to fill us in more. What we do know is all signs point to the F-130s being hacked, and whoever did it has had them engaged in a dogfight for the past hour over the eastern Conejo Valley. They've worked their way south to where they're just a few miles from our current location.
Breaking the path of Los Angeles in the process. I bet the press is all over this.
No, we told them that the jets were running combat simulations. We can't have the world know that we're not in control of our own warplanes. All of the aircraft has been grounded and disabled.
You look terrible.
That's right, you look like you're gonna be sick.
Yeah, because I'm looking at you in pajamas.
You know, we rushed over here. Where's Abby?
She's on her way.
Should be very comfortable. What about the others?
Paige, Tim, Walter. They just landed from Tahoe. They'll be here any minute.
Walter went up to Tahoe? Oh boy, I'm gonna be confused.
Navy personnel will be here soon. Grab a coffee, perk up. It's gonna be a long day.
Before the others get here, we should talk. Let's skip your rejection of my proposal because you are married. Great surprise, by the way. And get to the lies.
I've never lied to you.
Really? I hacked LA County records. There's no marriage license for you, so either you're not married or you deleted the evidence so I can find out who your better half is.
One, I am married. Two, I didn't delete anything. Three, I don't lie to you. Four, I'm in love with you.
That's gonna make things weird for your anniversary, won't it? Is it Collins?
What?
When he kidnapped me, he said he couldn't say yes to my proposal. Why would he say that?
Same reason he talks to sock puppets, because he's bat poop crazy.
Right, you're being truthful, not Collins.
Doc, look, do you trust me?
No.
Fine, do you love me?
Yeah.
Then if your love is stronger than your distress, please understand that I'm in a situation with another guy who I don't love, who I have never loved, but that's all I can tell you.
Why?
Toby, that's all I can tell you right now. But if you give me a little bit of time, I will fix it and tell you everything, okay?
Crap, now I trust you too.
Good. Now there are two F-130s screaming across LA, so we've got more important things to worry about.
Sly, Kate filled me in earlier.
Right, on your way back from Tahoe.
Shouldn't you be sleeping? Sly, while we're waiting for the Admiral to get here, link up to the Naval Base's operating system. See if you can find a backdoor into those planes.
I am already into it.
What is that nonsense?
This is super fun guy Cuckoo Clay. I'm stressed and it helps.
Two hands.
Okay, look, does anybody have a read on where these planes are right now?
There's your answer.
Look for vulnerable ports on the military wireless server networks.
And I just got the Navy's radar feed up on our monitors.
They're circling L.A. They run out.
Okay, that was the world's most awkward plane ride. Oh, good gravy, you didn't tell it.
Refuse to engage.
Oh, please. You can hack in your sleep. I'm hardly a distraction. You know, I read this article about this guy in San Pedro who has the two largest aluminum foil balls in SoCal. He charges $1 to see him. Do you know what I admire most about this guy with those giant balls? Do you know what attribute really stands out for the giant balls guy, Walter?
I will tell her how I feel when I get the chance, but right now they're out of control. F-130 screaming across LA, so we have more important things to worry about.
I've never heard that before.
Admiral. Hey, Gallo. Any updates?
No. All we can obtain is a brief recording of the pilots. After that, the hackers cut the comms. Best tech minds in government couldn't crack it.
We're the best tech minds in the government.
You're being smart with me.
Actually, we're smart with everybody.
The world's superpower can't control its aviation. I'm getting sass from this guy and a giant baby in his underwear.
They don't need any disrespect. That's just them being themselves.
Can I talk to you for a second?
Quick question. This might be the biggest case that this team has ever had, and I'm worried that Walter might be a little unfocused.
No matter what it is, Walter always gets the job done, so...
Yeah, but what about him just appearing in Tahoe saying he was there to hear jazz? I mean, do you believe that? I mean, he obviously wanted to see you badly enough that he was willing to drive through the night to do it, so...
I don't know. I hope not. Things are much simpler if that's not the case.
Really? How so?
Hey, did you mess with my marriage records?
Absolutely, I did. Do you want Toby to find out who you're really married to? Just focus on the matter at hand. Speaking of which,
excuse me, guys, we could use all hands on deck.
Right, and we are right here with you, Walter.
Just need everyone fixed on the case.
And like I said, we are right here with you. Okay, it's not like I can help you hack a military computer.
Good God, Woodrow's locked on Morales.
Woodrow, you are locked in!
It's not me! My fire control is completely disabled! Al, you're right in the crosshairs! Oh, God.
They can't eject, we gotta disarm those weapons now.
What do you think we're trying to do?
They're heading towards the ocean!
Just went live. Why would they turn her comms back on now?
This is Blackjack One, Lieutenant Commander Woodrow. Does anyone copy?
Blackjack One,
this is Admiral Pace. I'm here with Homeland Agent Cape Gowan and independent team. I'm trying to get you landed safely.
I have no control of my aircraft. I am currently in an auto loop pattern.
I just shut down my wingman, Lieutenant Morales, over the Pacific.
Lieutenant Commander, what's your first name, Cape?
June.
June? This is Dr. Curtis with Scorpion, the team the Admiral just mentioned. Listen carefully. You didn't shoot down your friend.
Yeah, hackers who took over your plane fired that weapon. You're responsible for nothing.
I need to take this. Woodrow, fill in Agent Gallo. Give him a full debriefing.
First, my airspeed increased independently, then altitude. I lost all flight controls and communications. One system failure after another.
That's why the hackers turned on her comms. They wanted us to hear blow by blow how an F-130 was systematically usurped. They wanted June to debrief us so we could hear how good they are at their jobs. It's an advertisement, a psychological tool. They are smart. This is just the beginning.
I just got off the phone with DC. Four U.S. destroyers have been cyberjacked and positioned 300 yards outside of Miami, Boston, Portland, and Long Beach. High-explosive BGM missiles are pointed directly at each of those cities. All of our aircraft, our battleships have been grounded, and we've shut down our nuclear silos. The United States, as of right now, is a nation without defense.
USS Hawthorne, USS Crittenden, Corbett, and Rooney, all under hacker control.
Are you evacuating the cities?
We do that. The story gets out, we've lost control over our military.
I can think of a few nations that would act immediately if they knew we were defenseless.
Okay, can't you manually disengage the missiles on the destroyers?
No, most ships' magazines have automated blast doors. Assume they've been closed by the hackers and the crew's been locked out from the missiles.
Exactly what happened.
And you know that for certain? You've been in contact with the ship?
Yes. The comms are working.
If he can talk to the ships and we can talk to June, can the hackers hear us right now and any plans we might devise?
You know, I'm not too worried about these hackers. Took them an hour of joysticking around to bring down a plane.
If they had real skills, they'd have June doing scissors and rolls right now.
Someone shut that guy up!
What are you thinking?
Okay, see? The punks that are behind this don't speak English. If they did, they'd have sent June into a tailspin because I just called them out, and they are egomaniacal, highly intelligent, and antisocial.
So are we.
But they are businessmen. They position ships at the four corners of the country. Why? Symbolic. Got you boxed in. They are trying to prove themselves to potential clients who want to bring the U.S. to its knees. These guys are bright, 18 to 25, because young people are driven to prove themselves. And if I had to guess, Eastern European, because instead of focusing on our monetary system or electrical grid, they went after our military. These are children of Cold War parents who grew up hearing about the mighty U.S. war machine. And I bet they smoked those skinny Euro cigarettes. That's how you profile.
Okay, let's assume Toby's right.
I am.
So Sly, focus on Eastern Europe. See if we can track the signal that's hacking June's plane. If we find the hackers, we end all of this. All right, Ralph, do you think you can run a rehash check, see if they're pulling this off of the DDoS attack?
Sure. But can I get some Fruity Moons or something?
You find the European hackers, I'll get you Fruity Moons.
Unbelievable.
Lieutenant Commander, can you stay with us while we sort this out?
Don't have much of a choice.
Happy and I'll jump on the dark web, see if anyone's bragging about what they did to Uncle Sam.
No need. I just traced the hack to a section of Sofia, Bulgaria.
Eastern Europe. Wow, who could have predicted that?
Looks like they jumped into a signal from a Pentagon white shoe out of Long Beach.
What's a white shoe?
Pentagon keeps nondescript buildings in most U.S. cities. They're there to maintain relay signals for military operations.
That's how they're controlling the ships. They're infiltrating white shoe signals in Boston, Miami, Portland, and here.
They're using our own signals to control our ships?
What kind of bully makes you hit yourself?
So if we can get to the White Shoe office in Long Beach, then I can hack their server, see if I can figure out a way to disrupt the hacker's signal. Then I tell the authorities in the other three cities how to do it, and then we kill the signal simultaneously and regain control of the ships. Now, Toby, I left my car in Tahoe, and Paige is at her house, so we'll need to borrow yours.
Okay, but I just had it washed in OA, so be careful with it.
Really? So you and Paige? Why not Sylvester and Paige?
No, Sly will be with you and Cabe on the way to Bulgaria to find the hackers.
Oh, so you stay with Paige and you ship me off to Bulgaria.
Tim.
Easy, buddy.
Sly can handle whatever the hackers throw at him tech-wise, and you two are necessary law enforcement in a foreign country. It's a logical way to divide workload.
Oh, yeah. It's a load, all right.
Well, if you don't agree with my decision-making, perhaps you should change your homeland assignment.
And perhaps you should just tell us what you were doing in Tahoe, Walter.
Okay, this is not the schoolyard. We got some serious work to do. Got it?
Got it.
Got it.
Tim, Walter's the boss. We follow his lead.
Yes, sir. Truth is, as much as I hate flying, I'm excited to get out of this barrage between Tim and Walter and Happy and Toby. It's too tense. I'm getting out of my gym jams.
All aircraft are grounded. How are you going to find a plane that can go at least Mach 4 and get you to Bulgaria in 2 hours?
Don't worry, I got an idea.
Speaking of planes, if the hackers pick up that we're messing with their signal, they will drive June's plane into the ground.
Or, if this takes too long,
there's always the chance she runs out of gas and crashes.
That's exactly what we want.
It's not what I want.
No, no, hear me out. If June does a fuel dump, the plane will plummet instantly, because swept-wing aircraft have the glide capacity of a rock. So I can calculate it so it nosedives for our garage.
With the engine off, the hackers won't be able to control the plane.
And then we just get the plane's original unhacked firmware back onto the jet's computer.
And I can do it with this.
With a stud finder?
You know, I can't go near stud finders. They always go off.
You've told that joke before, okay? Happy.
Data can be sent over the lasers. I can send new firmware directly into the jet's comm system.
It has an independent battery. Even with the engine off, it can accept the data.
And it's housed in the nose of the plane that will point towards us as it falls to Earth.
By us, am I safe to assume you're going to put me in the path of a plummeting F-130?
I will build the laser from the stud finder, some laser levels, and Sly's laser tag guns. You will prep the firmware.
Okay, June, you'll have to be no more than 500 feet from the rooftop to guarantee that the download works.
We'll have seconds to restart my engine solely on fumes, pull out of a nosedive, and skim over rooftops to a safe landing somewhere.
Aha! The safest bet is the L.A. riverbed, 4 miles east of here.
Million to one shot, but it could work.
Almost ready. Happy laser update?
Don't worry about me. Do your job.
God forbid something goes wrong. We get crushed. I'm really concerned for your widower. Think I'll handle it well?
Okay, that's it. We're done talking.
How goes it with you? To be honest, it's kind of awkward.
She meant, how close are we to the Pentagon office?
Oh.
Yeah, we're not that far out at all. Sly, are the calculations ready for June?
Getting the final specs now. June, I need to know the entire weight of your plane, including you and your flight suit, the wingspan of your plane, and your current velocity.
Hey! You Bruce?
Yes, sir. We talked on the phone.
I have to remind you that all you were told is highly confidential. You repeat any of it, it's a felony.
I'm a Vietnam vet and a patriot. My lips are sealed. And I got this baby. Fueled and prepped. It'll hit Mach 4, have you in Bulgaria faster than you get home in L.A. traffic.
And it's not computerized at all?
Nothing to hack.
And he secured us a pilot?
You're looking at him. I know what you're thinking, but I was a good pilot back in my day.
How many missions?
None. Right after my training, we had a fire in my barracks. I burned my hands bad, so they grounded me. I helped others get ready to fight, but I never got to do my part myself. So please... let me serve my country.
Okay, June is ready. Is this guy gonna take us to meet our pilot? Oh, poop.
We've got the main power cable and 2 backups in case of failure.
Okay, I'm almost done. Hook him up.
Lenny.
Huh?
Jared.
What are you doing?
What? Nothing. Norman, Jared, Byrne.
You're calling out men I know to see if I show guilt markers?
Maybe.
Byrne's my deli guy.
Yeah, I've seen how he handles your role alone.
You're an idiot.
No, I'm just hurt and angry. Do you have any idea how what I'm going through feels? It feels like you just took my heart and tore it from my body. They're covered in flies. Even the dog doesn't want it, even though he ate it in the first place. That's what's left of my heart.
Hate to interrupt the fighting, but I need to make sure your heads are in the game before I dump my fuel.
We're fine. Toby's shutting up now.
Good. Because if the hackers keep up the same loop pattern, I'll be over you again in minutes. And once my tanks are in empty, I'll be heading into a complete vertical nosedive.
Yep, straight down right at us at terminal velocity.
Hey, check, don't say terminal.
Take you at your word that you were in Tahoe for the festival, but
Tim does not take me at my word. That's his prerogative, but I told the truth.
Be that as it may, you heard the ammo. The U.S. is being forced into a civil war. Our weapons being forced against ourselves.
And we don't need the scorpion turning against itself as well, but with me and Tim and Toby and Happy, we are, and that's not ideal when the stakes are high. Understood.
So for now, just steer clear of Tim. Understood?
Just tell me.
that you give away tickets to a jazz festival and show up anyway.
We should put our cars back in.
2 kilometers from the fuel dump. Position, bring her in nice and steady.
How about extremely fast and out of control?
Forgive me getting a little beat up about this plan.
Beat it up, sweaty, worried.
I know my pilot terms. Lieutenant?
That fancy plane you're flying?
All the minds who designed it compared to us, they're morons, so no need to sweat it.
She should be terrified.
Okay, you should be in position in 2, 1. Ring the Admiral's doorbell. That means dump the fuel.
That one I didn't know.
There it goes. Engine shutting down.
Oh, man, here she comes. Right for our butts.
Firing the laser.
2 degrees north.
How are you doing down there? The laser's locked on your nose, uploading the firmware. Estimating at 3 nautical miles from your roof. You might want to bail. We bail, the laser could shift and you'd die. We're staying.
If these are our last moments together, I propose we die with no secrets between us.
No.
I'll go first. Sometimes when I'm alone in the garage, I sniff your work gloves.
Great, now I can die disgusted. Guys, another time.
A mix of lavender hand cream and motor oil reminds me of your emotional dichotomy.
10 seconds to the envelope. Pass that high prep pullout. The jet's getting awfully big. 8 seconds.
Okay, now your turn. Who is your husband?
Made it. LA Riverbed is my bingo. Fuel's at zero. I'm setting down. Thank you. To you and your whole team.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah.
You gonna answer that question or what?
I've given to you my heart and my soul more than I've ever given to anyone. Now, in your head, that may not add up to 100%. Tough. The 1% is the price of admission to Happy Land. You have to pay. I am not an open book. Get used to it!
I'm not in Happy Land. I'm in Angry World. Next stop, Resentment Town.
That's your team we're listening to?
Not if I can help it. I'm gonna take this calm out until we land.
You know, you played my hand. Now I have no choice but erasure. And I don't mean the delightful synth pop duo.
What is this?
Oh, I'm literally and figuratively sweeping away the proposal. It's hereby rescinded.
Like hell it is.
What do you care? You're married.
I am going to fix it.
My proposal was a contractual offer. All of me for all of you. You can't meet my terms, so offer off the table. Pardon me.
Okay, NATO's granted us permission to land. Under the cover that we're U.S. military delivering the Valkyrie for Bulgarian training.
We've been combing through the Eastern European dark web, and the name that keeps coming up regarding criminal matters in Sofia is one Dmitry Borosevich, a.k.a. Na Skunks.
What does that mean?
The Skunk. He appears to be the underground kingpin of the city.
Yeah, international warrants for wire fraud, identity theft, gambling rings.
Well, Sofia isn't a big town, so if he's not behind the hacks, he'll be getting kickbacks from the people who are.
Find the Skunk, find the hackers.
Putting together cultural protocols for Bulgaria, there's a few things you'll need on the ground. This isn't an engineering or mechanical issue, so pardon.
Gentlemen, when we touch down, I recommend expediency. It won't take the Bulgarian military long to see through that training jet story.
All right, I'll just give you Bulgarian essentials.
No is yes, yes is no.
Come again?
It's unique to the country.
For yes, they shake their head. For no, they nod up and down.
No way that could cause confusion.
I agree completely. That felt way too odd.
Government building on a Saturday. It's abandoned.
You can get us in here?
Well, you can't be friends with Happy Quinn for 7 years without learning stuff.
Okay.
Came into the Pentagon server 3 minutes, and I'll shut down the signal controlling the Corbett.
Boy, that thing looks mean.
If things get hot, don't be a hero. You're a civilian. You get on that plane and go home.
I am not going to abandon you guys.
Hey, found more on El Skunko. Latest
arrest, 4 in the last 2 months, all for gambling, all out of one building in a slum in the Nadaja area of Sofia.
I'll send the address.
So what are we supposed to do when we get there? Just politely ask to meet the Skunk?
It's like walking into Little Italy and asking to see Don Corleone.
You gotta make him want to talk to you.
We gotta get in his game, take enough of his money to get his attention.
Doesn't seem like the type of guy who'd take too favorably to that.
Looks like you'll find out, Sly.
I am. Why me?
I mean, do you really want me and Cabe running odds on dealt hands? No. You're the man for the job.
I had the consulate get us 10 grand for a gambling stake.
Cabe, is that the car you got for us?
Yeah, I told the embassy we needed something so we'd fit in.
We're not gonna fit in that!
Just downloading the last of the software and then done.
Should be done in a minute or so.
Toby, load's almost ready. How are Sly and...
comms don't work in here. The walls are aluminum, forming a Faraday cage. The windows are protected by scrambling data technology. The Pentagon does not like bugging.
Beautiful view.
Yeah. So there might have been another reason why I drove to Tahoe beyond my interest in jazz.
Okay.
I believe that this team functions best under the policy of openness and honesty, and I wasn't honest earlier. So, Paige, for a long time, I wanted to tell you something, and...
Oh, my gosh.
I know, it's a big deal, so it's time that I finally say it.
Walter, look, it's coming right at us.
Oh, boy, that's a missile.
Light speed of their ballistic missile, 800 kilometers an hour, 497...
How long do we have, Walter?
50 seconds. No, it took over a minute to get up here by elevator. Stairs are too small.
What do we do then?
Here, I have an idea. Hold slice, cuckoo, clay.
Yeah, how did the hackers know we were trying to interrupt the signal?
They must have been monitoring connection traffic from that server room.
Either way, Walt and Paige have 38 seconds until Kablooey.
Not good.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Okay. Now, cover your hands. Insulized cuckoo clay will protect our hands, but also has a low coefficient of friction, so we'll slide down fast. Descent should only take a few seconds.
Fewer if we fall. Okay, how long until the missile hits?
20 seconds. We gotta go faster! What do you mean there's a missile headed for them?
How is missile heading for them confusing?
We can't cover!
I can't believe this is happening.
I think we're okay.
Cable's gonna snap.
Get us out of here! Okay. Yeah.
Over and over! Hurry! Okay. Get up! You okay?
Yeah.
Hurry, we gotta get out of here. The heat from the missile ionized the air. It's disrupted the signal. We need to get back to the garage.
Yeah, the transportation problem.
Toby is having a bad 24 hours.
Hey.
Paige, are you okay? It's been radio silence.
Yes, then we're both fine. Thank you, Brad.
But the Pentagon is going to need a new relay server.
And a new building put in.
Guys, the destroyers are still under hacker control. Their signal wasn't even interrupted for a second.
They spoofed the signal to the White Shoe office to sniff out anyone who could be posing a threat. They're not really using the Pentagon relay system. They must be using a satellite.
Yes, sending code directly to the ship's operating system.
The U.S. can't shoot down any satellites because we disabled all our missiles this morning.
Can you hack the satellite?
I need to get back to the garage. Cabe, we're stranded.
Only I can get you a car.
Wait, hi. Where's my car?
Tell me what's the number his car is.
Oh, God.
Kind of all over.
What does that mean?
We just texted your homeland's local office.
Okay, I'll call him.
Okay. Dave, those guys are smart. You need to find them soon.
They will. Long as Sly wins at Baccarat. All right, kid, we gotta jump. We just got to where we're supposed to be. This is Skunk's HQ. Total dump with chauffeurs and nice cars out front.
Translation, it's a casino. I think you guys are significantly overestimating my gambling abilities.
Now, you can take that house blindfolded in death, which you will be, essentially, because I'm sure they jammed communications to prevent cheating.
Listen, Sly, these guys, they're just animals. All you gotta do is gain their respect, okay? Be the alpha, control the game, own the room.
He's right, Sly.
Oh. If someone tries to take something from you, you take it back. Don't ever let someone take something from you that's important.
I think Timbo's talking about the waitress.
Remember, the fate of the free world may be in your hands. You win every cent you can, as fast as you can, to draw Skunk out.
Okay, I guess. But, what exactly are the rules of Baccarat?
Oh, good, you're here. Yeah, I want to use my phone to begin a trace of satellites in geosynchronous orbit over Los Angeles. What? Did you get home instead of car?
I did. I also accidentally saw one of your texts. Hello, Mr. Armstrong. This is the concierge at the Tahoe Crystal Lake Resort. We got your message and are happy to change your reservation from adjoining rooms to separate singles. You changed the reservation?
There's an explanation.
Did you also call the dining room pretending to be the Board of Health? What the hell did you do, Walter?
private club.
U.S. contractors. My friend's looking for a game.
Private club.
Here's our membership.
Clem check for guns. Tough joint.
This way.
Of the way through an 8-deck shoe, it should make counting a little bit easier.
Bet?
Yes! Banker, player, tie. I will bet on player. That's me, because I believe in myself. 8,000.
Who's bet 8,000 on a single hand?
Well, I'm gonna stay on the natural. Go ahead, that's a 5, you can draw. That's a bust! Ooh. This is fun!
And again, very fast, very quickly.
Perfect.
Paige, maybe we should stay in one place so that the homeland car can find us?
I'm walking to the freeway off-ramp, they can find me there.
Maybe that is more efficient.
It is not about efficient, Walter, it is about getting away from you!
You're upset?
Wow, you are a genius. I'm gonna take this out so the team can hear what I'm about to say.
You can actually leave the comm in. We're still within range of the missile ionization.
I am taking this out as an indicator of me doing whatever the hell I want without some stupid genius telling me what to do.
Fair enough.
Why did you call the hotel?
Because
you are a jealous infant who can't find your own way to happiness, so you choose to disrupt the happiness of everyone else.
Well, not intentionally.
I can't believe you sabotaged me. I've been waiting 2 years to tell you this, Walter. You were wrong.
That's what's called hitting the tie. You know, statistically, betting on the tie is an idiotic move, but not when you know what you're doing.
You're doing quite well. You and friends would like to go VIP?
Yeah, that sounds like fun.
You did it. Now meet the skunk.
Yep.
Yeah.
This is Admiral Pace.
Give me Gallo.
Sorry, he's at a comm range watching Sylvester play Baccarat in an underground Bulgarian casino with a criminal named Skunk.
What?
How can we help, Admiral?
Get word to Gallo that all the nuclear subs have returned to base except for one. Ohio class to Clayton. It's gone missing off the coast of Southern California.
Are you saying the hackers are controlling a sub with nukes on it?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
I'd like to explain myself.
I don't want to hear it. There's no excuse.
That's true, but there is context.
I don't care.
I went to Tahoe to tell you I love you.
Hey, Walter. We're out of the card room and your comms are up and running again. When we get out of here, we're gonna have a little talk.
So we're just gonna stand here, or one of you guys gonna ask us to dance? You must be Skunk. It's a pleasure.
Baccarat is practically a coin flip, but you hit 15 hands in a row. You cheat.
No, once the shoe is down to 2 decks, it's the simplest math.
He's a math genius. I'm just trying to get your attention.
If we wanted a meeting with the main man of Sophia, we knew that wouldn't come cheap. Your reputation precedes you all the way to the U.S.
You're really something.
You got my attention. Who are you?
We do financial reappropriation in the cybersphere.
Online bank thieves.
Yeah, we farmed out a job to a group in Sofia. Hackers. Gave them all the intel on the bank, paid them their fee, they stole the cash, never turned over a dime.
Too bad for you.
We figure anybody working in this area pays you a regular tribute. So for their address, we'll give you the money we earned, our 10 grand buy-in, and a finder's fee if the intel nabs the bugs.
You okay?
Which are missing?
Ace of diamonds, two of spades, king of clubs.
Only people who can pull off what you say are called the bootleggers. I give you information, you give me him.
Me?
For just one game. There is Chinese whale, Ching Wei, been wiping me out. He plays today. I want to back my lev.
I think you might need to find another math genius to help you win back your lev. Okay?
Okay. Kid, these bootleggers have taken out a fighter jet, control four Navy destroyers, and now they have a sub with nukes on it.
We're talking the balance of the free world here, Sly.
So pretend to scratch your ear, take your comm out, give it to me. Can't be found on you. We'll be back to get you after the threat is neutralized.
You're serious?
Has a heart attack.
Like the one I'm about to have?
Okay, Stump. You got a deal.
So the hack sub is somewhere off the coast of California, but whether it's going north or south is anyone's guess, including the sub captain.
Okay, they're in communication with Admiral Pace, but their sonar, depth finder, and radar have all gone dark.
The fastest way to find the sub would be to use the sonar capabilities of the USS Corbett.
But the Corbett's under control of the hackers.
So we'll need a top-down approach.
You get it top-down, because the Corbett's being controlled by a satellite that's above them. It's top-down.
I'm gonna clean up some more confetti.
Top-down, that's brilliant. We can't destroy the satellite because the missiles are grounded, but if we can disrupt the satellite signal before it gets to the ship, then we can regain control of the destroyer.
But even if we disrupt the signal, you can't reprogram the Corbett's computers without physically being on the boat.
You try to go out to that destroyer, Walt, I guarantee you the hackers will use the ship's weaponry to turn you into Swiss cheese. And it's moot anyway because we have no way to disrupt the hacker's sat signal to the ship.
Yes, we do. Confetti.
What about it?
If we create a metallic shower like confetti in the air above the ship,
it will interfere with the satellite signal long enough for us to regain control of the destroyer's computers.
Except the forecast only calls for a chance of silver with a light drizzle of copper. How the hell are you gonna make it rain aluminum?
Easy. Happy just needs to borrow father's flatbed, get to the weapons museum where Kay got the Valkyrie from, and then commandeer a trebuchet. Paige and I are gonna visit your friend in San Pedro, Toby, the one with the giant balls.
So, I'm sorry, what?
Drop your pants.
Pardon me?
You change. Look like us, or Ching Wei gets suspicious, won't play you.
I have an issue with changing in public.
Ching Wei is good player. Clever, smart cheater. You out-cheat him.
Oh, no. I intend to play with my intellect, because cheaters get hurt.
Don't worry about his gunmen. We have our own. Shooting stars just hit the deck. Once you've taken him for 3 million, U.S. will shut down the game. You go home. Here. Final touch. It belonged to Oleg.
What happened to Oleg?
Turn left in 1.3 miles.
You know, you haven't said a whole hell of a lot since Walter said he loved Paige.
I'm concentrating on the mission.
You're stewing.
I'm not. I feel like Walter was dishonest.
This might sound odd, but behaviorally, it might be progress for Walter.
Yeah, well, he and I still need to have a little talk.
Does that include him getting slugged in the mouth?
It's an option currently being considered.
I'll move off it. I'm not gonna let that happen. Besides, if you even get in a glancing blow, you'd probably pop his head off. These guys are smart. They're not sturdy.
Turn. You okay?
You're happy and Toby are a minute out.
I know. I heard their call.
It's very kind of that gentleman with the aluminum balls to let us rent his truck.
You said that 3 times.
Just acknowledging a human kindness.
Walter, accept the fact that by sabotaging my weekend with Tim, you acted horribly. Also accept the fact that this topic won't be discussed until I'm ready to discuss it, okay? You are not in control.
Okay. It's good to know. Oh, good. They're here. We brought the solution straight from 300 BC. Okay, let's get set up fast.
I'll call Admiral Pace, make sure he's downloaded our plan to the 3 other cities.
She doesn't know what I muttered over the comms.
How about being in love with her?
She doesn't need to know that. And besides, what you heard was out of context.
Oh, put it in context.
I prefer that we forget it happened.
Right. We'll pretend you don't love Paige, and I'll pretend Happy isn't married to some yahoo. What's amazing is the sanest thing we'll do today is launch an enormous aluminum ball at a battleship. I'm teaming with her today. I will set up the trebuchet and dial in the trajectory.
Okay, I'm heading to the marina to hotwire you a boat.
Once the satellite signal is blocked, you need to be on the destroyer. You only have 2 minutes to reprogram the system.
Actually, 90 seconds.
Okay, authorities in Miami, Portland, and Boston have all collected their aluminum and are creating their projectiles. After what happened with high-rise in Long Beach, Admiral Pace believes that if this doesn't work, the hackers will launch all remaining missiles onto U.S. soil. Walter, this is a real gamble.
Remember, no talking. Your accent gives you away. He's got to think you're one of us.
Happy? I spoke with the captain of the Corbett. They're expecting me.
Are you expecting what the hackers will do when you get close?
They'll open fire with the forward guns.
This is not bulletproof, and neither are you.
Yeah, well, I have a plan.
Dodging bullets in a boat is not a plan!
This has a shot if Walter can make it out to that ship.
No gunfire yet. Maybe the hackers aren't looking through the ship's security cameras.
You were saying?
Cody, verify the trebuchet. I don't have much time here.
Okay. All the other cities are ready for the order.
3 seconds. I'm through this rope. Then it's Great Falls of Fire. 3, 2, 1, fire! Midnight meal for the proposal celebration, which, of course, never happens.
Okay, just get it! Okay, Paige, help me retie the trigger rope.
On it.
200,000. Drink. Have a drink. It's tradition. Do not offend my guest.
How many cards? One card? Yes, one card. I understand.
You have to discard.
A drone straight.
A confused kind. Why can't you guys just nod yes and no like every other country?
Fresh rinse of bell hair cuts and shampoo. Warlock's Jazz Comic Store?
I use punch cards. It's silly if you don't. It's like leaving your money on the table. That was a poor choice of words. I'm sorry.
Pass. With stamp for a U.S. government employee discount.
Online bank thieves, I doubt it. Your friend with the slick hair, his name was Gallo, huh? I wound big for Skunk. He's taking me out for a celebration dinner.
We're not actually going to a celebration dinner, are we?
The guys keep on firing whether I go forward or retreat. I'm dead if you don't hurry.
Master Toby.
Rust, corrosion. You never see it forming, and then one day it's there. You know why?
I know why, and it's not because of the analogy you're about to make.
Because of neglect. Because foreign elements, like air and water, reacting with the iron. Elements the iron never saw coming. Elements the iron was completely blindsided
by. Guys, Walter's being shot at.
All I'm saying is...
Oh, boy. Miami, Portland, Boston, launch your balls.
It worked! The hackers don't have control of the guns anymore.
Captain, do you have a status report?
We have control of the missile.
Well, get the hell on that boat.
Hell of a ride in, Mr. O'Brien. I'm Captain Connor.
The bridge captain now.
You don't stand on ceremony.
Well, I don't reprogram your firmware within 90 seconds. Your ship goes back into the hands of the hackers.
We're losing our aluminum cover.
10 seconds. The firmware is reprogrammed. All the other ships have to do is open this email and click the file.
All the ships have the file and the instructions.
We have a clear sky. Did this work?
Yep.
Portland. Portland, Boston, Miami are back in our Navy's control.
We're manually disabling all weapons till this threat is gone.
It's a good start. Now we need to find that missing nuclear sub.
We may be taking a stinger out of this operation soon. Tim and I are pulling up to the hacker location Skunk gave us. That's a building.
Hey, hold on, that's a building too.
Man, every apartment on this block is 236 Jacobna.
There must be 50 units. There's no way we got time to check them all.
Hey, listen up. I got 500 American for some information.
Are all these units 236 Jacobna?
236 A, B, C, D. All right, which one of them has a bunch of teenage boys with computer skills? I tell you for 1,000. You know, the only thing I hate more than street drug dealers is one that makes my job harder.
Listen, you get them out here, you get your grand.
Okay? You're a very angry man.
Boss? I'm stuck in the middle of Bulgaria with no leads and no time.
Thanks. Maybe not.
Stick with him!
Give it up, kid.
He came and yammed a while at the drugate.
No idea what you just said.
I'm pretty sure that was Bulgarian for Al. Nothing. No sign of the sub. Best course of action is to get this ship to shore before something else goes wrong.
What's that over there?
That's just an air pocket created by a massive school of fish. It's nothing.
Well, it depends if the air is made of oxygen or something else. The Pacific herring will pass gas to create distracting bubbles to confuse predators.
You think the fish are farting away from the submarine?
Possibly. Just hold the sonar for a moment. See what's coming up behind this fish.
I want to find this missing sub as bad as you do, but there's nothing
over there. From the west.
It's the sub.
This is Walter O'Brien, a government tech contractor on board the USS Corbett trying to contact the Clayton. Do you copy, Clayton?
Clayton, do you copy?
This is Captain Brayden of the USS Clayton. I hope you have some info regarding our whereabouts.
We've been flying blind for some time now.
Captain, you are headed due east. Your craft is approaching the McEwen pipeline.
Okay, now we know where I'm at, but I still don't have control over my ship.
Understood.
Finding you was step one. Bringing you and your nuclear weapons in safely is step two. Just not sure how to do that yet.
Oh, that's our answer. When I was a kid, I got a metal detector for my birthday, and I tested it out by putting it up against our old tube TV. It created a magnetic field that ruined the set. Dad was not happy.
So you want to create a magnetic field in the water to disrupt the hacker's link to the sub's computer system?
We can use the McEwen pipeline. It's metal. If we put enough strong magnets inside, it'll create a palpable magnetic field.
And when the sub passes through the field and the hacker signal is disrupted, we reboot back control, and the Clayton quickly gets to the surface and powers down the sub.
Once we power down, they won't be able to retake control of the vessel. We just float, wait for rescue.
One question. How do we get magnets inside a pipe that's full of thousands of gallons of oil?
We hack the system and drain the pipe. I can swing it.
The base has several decommissioned railguns. They're full of industrial-grade magnets.
Captain, call the base. Tell them we're on our way.
You know, Bulgaria is lovely. But not always. Like in 1928, when you guys had that massive earthquake and then America sent a bunch of aid to help rebuild the region. America and Bulgaria getting along.
You lost me 250,000 lead. There's no talking your way out of this.
I only lost 210,000. There were still chips on the table when I was getting pulled away.
Why don't you shut up?
I lost exactly $29,420, and the bulge in this guy's pocket is approximately 1.75 inches thick, which makes sense since the international standard for currency paper is 0.0043 inches thick. 400 $100 lev bills would be 1.72 inches thick, which is just about my estimate.
I say be quiet. No, you be quiet. What are you saying?
In short, Mr. Skunk, the gorilla next to me has pocketed the money.
He's lying. Pull over.
cash in the chips. I forgot I put money in the pocket. Here. Honest mistake.
Let's go.
Toye burrata. Now let me go!
How many magnets do we need?
Happy said at least 12.
It's a completely shut off oil flow for good. Would take hours, but best I can do is make the pipeline run a diagnostic test. That'll stop the oil flow for about 12 minutes, thus draining the pipe. But once the time's up, the oil flow restarts. Anyone still in the pipe drowns in oil.
Oh, sounds lovely.
Got the reboot protocol ready for the sub, but you guys have to hurry. The ETA for the pipeline is 10 minutes.
Because we're out of the hatch, drop this on the pipe, the charge will electrify the magnetic field.
Where did you get that?
Let's just say the officer's club doesn't have air conditioning anymore.
You're a real live wire, you know that?
Guys, time's a factor.
Right. Shutting off oil flow now. Happy, Paige, let's get in that hatch and get that pallet inside.
Where are your friends?
Listen, I'm not Walter, so I can't make heads or tails of what's on this thing. My best guess is that after the hackers realized that people were onto them in the U.S., they ran off, set up shop in some other locale. This guy stayed behind with his tablet to keep the link to our military assets connected until his pals could finish up.
Walter, do you copy?
Okay.
I got nothing off this kid.
Tablet's gibberish. He doesn't speak any English. His pockets are empty except for some
cash, an employee ID card to a movie theater, and a gum wrapper.
He works in a movie theater?
Apparently. Why?
Most theaters show movies digitally now, so that's 900 gigabits per second, so its movies are beamed by satellite, which means that theater is one of the only places in Bulgaria that has the bandwidth necessary to implement a military-grade hack.
Who's Turk sent his pals to the movies?
Yeah, Paul, be by to get you before it gets too cold.
Okay.
No, my friends and I are in a lot of trouble, and I know it sounds crazy, but millions could die and they don't even know it. I need to use your phone.
I'm afraid I don't own a phone.
What about that thing?
Plays white noise only. I use to remove distractions when I converse with nature.
I can fix this to call my friends.
It is my husband Michael's, but he wants mine. What you need is yours.
Oh, thank you. The sub is 2 minutes from the pipeline. Guys, I need an update.
We're going as fast as we can. It's dark, the fumes are terrible, and we can barely see where we're going.
You guys okay? Happy?
Yeah, we're fine. Dirty, but fine.
Look for the hexagonal 13C seal. Put the magnets along that seam.
I found it!
Sonar's picked up mass readings of the magnetic field. It's working, but you guys have to hurry.
Really? Hurry! In a few minutes, the pipeline's diagnostic is over, and you are going to drown in liquid dinosaur.
Thank you, Billy.
You have done so much in so little time.
It's so peaceful here. You know, I really work better in a more calm environment. Where I work, everyone is so mad at each other. I really envy you and your husband's solitude.
You see, Michael, we got it so good. Even American is envious.
Oh, that is Michael? Ficus?
Yes.
Well, I hate to radio and run, but I just need to reset this crank so I can get a call up to my pilot.
It's time to finish our drive.
Thank you for your help. Shall we?
Okay, that's the last of them. Is that enough, Walter?
The magnetic field is strong and the sub's already entered it. But it won't disrupt the hacker signal unless there's an electric current running through it, so get out. Now. Sub's halfway through the field. Toby, get the current ready.
I'm holding on Sparky as I speak!
You drop that wire while Paige and Happy are still inside. The current's gonna ignite that residual oil and they will be burned alive.
Hey, Tim! I'm a genius! I know how fuel and electricity work!
Move it! Can't help it if I'm not wearing men's combat boots. They're called steel-toed work boots and they're headed for your butt if you don't grab my hand.
Guys, give or take 20 seconds and you're covered in oil!
Not in the fun bikini wrestling way.
The sub's almost out of the field. We're losing our window to regain control of the vessel.
Run!
You have 10 seconds. Where the hell are you guys?
Right here.
The magnetic field is perfectly charged, but the sub's pass through range. We missed it by seconds.
Confirmed.
But I still don't have control over my ship.
Walt, remember when you tried to screw with the signal from the Pentagon office and they destroyed a high-rise? What do you think they'll do now?
Sounds like retaliate. What you hear is a nuclear missile going into launch prep sequence.
The hackers are launching a warhead?
It's more peacocking. We're showing buyers the full extent of what they'll do if anyone tries to screw with them like we just did.
Preliminary data guarantees a strike on the continental United States.
Okay, we've got countdown on a missile that travels 14,000 miles per hour, and the only way to stop it is you getting to those hackers and snuffing the signal that's controlling all of this.
I'm driving a two-cylinder lawnmower, and I've got it floored, and we're still a few minutes from the theater.
That's going to be a problem, because this missile launches in less than 3 minutes, and I just ran the coordinates.
It's headed for Cody, Wyoming.
Population 10,000. Hackers made a very strategic choice. Demonstrate their destructive ability without completely crippling the country.
Because crippling the country is what they're going to be selling for billions. Oh, we're looking at a blast radius of 3 miles, immediately vaporizing all of Cody's residents.
With the fallout affecting millions.
I can assure you none of that is going to happen. The missiles won't fire because we can manually disengage our reactor, causing the sub to sink. The missile can't fire without power.
And your ship can't resurface, and you and your men die.
There's only 110 of us. It's a good trade.
Sir, you can't do that. You're only in this situation because I slipped on the incline, and we didn't get the wire on the pipe in time. Walter, it is my fault.
It's what we signed up for when we volunteered, ma'am.
No, Captain.
I understand the greater good concept better than anyone, but you're not thinking logically. With respect, we can find a way.
He's thinking like a military leader.
I only want to hear from geniuses at this moment.
But Cabe and I are the only ones that understand this situation, Walter.
Hey, if we want to stop America from attacking itself, we need to stop attacking each other. So shut up and grow up, because we have about a minute to save 110 sailors and over 10,000 people before that missile takes off.
Negative.
Our duty is to protect our nation's citizens, and I'm about to see it through.
Captain, you also have a duty to your crew. If you sacrifice their lives without getting all the facts, then you fail them as a leader. If my team says they can pull it off, they can pull it off. From one military man to another, trust us.
And it will require a lot of trust because I have a solution. But for it to work, the first thing you need to do, Captain, is allow that nuclear missile to launch.
I'm sorry, Walter. I thought I just heard you say that we should let the missile launch.
Yes.
Now, the nuke travels so fast that within seconds it'll be so far away from the sub that the sub-computer system will no longer control it.
Then the missile's own computer GPS kicks in, and Walter can hack that system.
We'll redirect the GPS and send it to a deep ocean trench with soft silt where it will settle without detonating.
That would be the Tongo Trench in the South Pacific. We have less than 30 seconds to the launch. You better be sure about this, Mr. O'Brien.
From launch to impacting Cody is about 3.8 minutes.
Once I start messing around with the missile's GPS, the hackers will see what I'm doing and then try and stop us. So whoever hacks the fastest wins. It's our only option.
Speaking of hackers, we're here.
The servers need to be kept cool so the top floors are easy to ventilate.
Countdown to launch.
5, 4, 3, 2, launch.
I'm into the missile's GPS.
The hackers are watching. They'll see pretty quickly.
They're in. They're rewriting my code as soon as I finish.
Well, don't let them.
Not that easy. Their advantage is they already hacked the sub's platform codes, which are also in the missile. So they have an 80-yard head start and a 100-yard dash.
Man, why do we always have to suck at sports?
They're setting up a permanent blocking program that'll stop me from redirecting the missile. I can't stop them. The best I can do is set up some roadblocks that'll slow them down until Cabe gets to them.
Clear.
Cabe?
Closing in on them now.
Hurry! The nuke detonates over Cody in 150 seconds. Right now, they're finishing a code that guarantees a nuclear strike. I'm watching their work as I speak. I'm barely slowing them down. Cabe, I'm throwing every hurdle I can at them. They're just an entry key away from countless people dying.
See, guys, prastima, nas vizitka, nas vida.
On the ground! Hands behind your head!
You don't move, I won't shoot you.
Okay, Walter, we disconnected this signal analog style. Do your thing.
Great work, Cabe. Entering the coordinates. Missile redirected.
This is Captain Braden. Happy to report we have full control over the vessel.
And all readings show our missile is headed directly to the Tongo Trench.
Okay, Tim and I will pick Sly up from dinner. We're on our way home.
Man, we're all sweating it out here, and Sly gets to gamble and have a fancy dinner. We'll have to trade places with that guy.
American Westerns always let the hero say last words. But this is not a movie.
That's okay. All I was going to say is duck. In American Westerns, the hero sometimes tells the bad guys to try their luck. But this isn't a movie.
I already wrecked it.
I thought I could, you know.
No, it's erect.
Okay, well, I thought it was going to be cool. So. Big guy. Oh, thank God. Here, please take this from me. All right.
Okay. Time to say goodbye.
How did you find out where I was?
Someone named Mikhail contacted the plane's radio, left coordinates in the woods. I picked up the car, followed you here. Feels good to have completed a real mission.
You said it was Mikhail who called?
Yeah, funny fella. Sounded like a girl. Let's go find your friends.
Okay, let's go.
Hello, Miss Deneen. This is the Tahoe Crystal Lake Resort. We're sorry your stay with us was cut short, but we'd like to offer you...
Everybody, I got Papa Tartini's. I got lasagna, eggplant parm, chicken parm. Cabe and Tim are debriefing homeland. They should be back soon. Oh, nobody touch Cabe's garlic bread. You know how he gets, right? You know, the reason I love Papa Tartini's is because they serve their food family style. And anyone who isn't willing to accept the family-style arrangements at Scorpion doesn't get to eat the family-style offerings, which is a shame because, in my experience, family-style has a lot of great benefits.
We get it. Your analogy is as heavy-handed as Toby's aluminum ball speech. Let's just eat.
No. It's been so tense around here that I wanted to leave you people for the first time in my life. And when I did, I got so far away, I was in the middle of nowhere, and you know what I learned? Being alone sucks. You wind up talking to plants. You guys are acting mad and weird around each other, and it's different. And I hate it. So, no. Nobody gets any food until I hear it.
I'm willing to eat family style. Toby, are you willing to eat family style?
Is this the whole family? Like you, me, and your husband?
Toby.
See?
Fine. I can eat family style. It's got to be a family of two.
I promise I will fix my situation.
Actually, I'm not that hungry.
All right. Papa Carpini's. You better not mess with my garlic bread.
Glad you guys are home again.
Gotta be home.
You meant to talk?
Sure.
So, earlier today, Tim wanted to knock your head off. I stood up for you, not because you're right, but because I care for you. And I know how bad it hurts to lose a woman you have feelings for.
Paige and I are only...
Stop it, son. In this area, I'm substantially smarter than you are. At the end of the day, Paige is an amazing person.
Agreed.
And you mess with her life. You pulled pranks to disrupt her relationship with Tim. That's high school nonsense.
Yeah, it wasn't my finest moment.
It hurts me to tell you this, but you like facts, so here it is. She deserves more than you're capable of giving her at this stage in your life.
I thought you cared for me.
And that's why I'm telling you this. You're not fully formed yet. You're almost there, but you're half-baked. And for you to try to go to win the love of a woman like Paige before you're ready is selfish and wrong. And it's not fair to her.
I'm concerned that if I wait too long... I've waited too long.
Yeah. You could lose her. But it's not about you. It's about Paige. It's about the whole team. It's about Ralph. He's a real stake, son.
Tim, I know you wanted to talk with me, but I think I can save us both time. I'm sorry for what I did. I won't cause any future problems.
Really?
Okay. Thank you. Okay.
Hey, Tim. You want a plate?
No, I'm good. Thank you. Paige and I are actually going to go pick up Ralph and then go to Betty's restaurant. Apple juice for the kid, live jazz for us.
I'm pooped. I'm gonna take my pasta home. Sly, I can give you a lift. Walter destroyed my ride, so I guess we'll take the company car.
Okay, I picked up so you can clean up.
I'm going to. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a good night, Walter.
Yeah. You too.
Hello, how may I help you?
Yes, hello, health department? Yeah, I would like to make a complaint about Betty's restaurant.
Sir, are you still there?
Yeah, you know, I made a mistake, sorry.
Stay tuned for scenes from our next episode.